So welcome to module 3.6. Now we will be dealing some one more important aspect, which is I/O handling. So when you design a computer, namely this hack, we need to have a method by which the user interacts with the system, and that is through inputs and outputs. So we'll have two simple input and output interface to hack. One of the interface is screen, through which we will see the outputs. Another interface is a keyboard, through which we will enter inputs to the system. And we need to understand how this input and output are actually happening in real time systems, and for that they use a concept of what we call as memory mapped I/O. That means whatever you want to output into the screen, you write it into a specific memory, and there will be a graphics controller which will take from that memory and put it onto the screen. So whatever you want to write on the screen, you write it into some memory, and from that memory some graphics, some hardware will take it and show it on the screen. So as far as the CPU, the hack that we are concerned, we will just write into the memory, and then we have some inbuilt screen controller which will go and show it on a screen. Similarly, even when you press a keyboard, whatever the code that we press will come and reside in a memory location, and the hack can basically read from that memory location to find out what the user has actually entered, right. So the way the hack talks to the communicates with the screen or to the keyboard is through memory locations. So this is called memory mapped I/O. Now for example, now what we have is, so the moment I have a I/O peripheral, an input peripheral or an output peripheral, immediately we assign certain memory address to that peripheral, that you will see in many systems, right. And why do we assign a memory address? Essentially we go and say that when I want to read or write to that input or output device, we essentially communicate through that memory. So now let us take the screen. The screen that we have is a 256 cross 512 black and white pixels, means pixel is nothing but, if you take a screen like this, the screen can be broken up into small dots. Rows of dots, a matrix of dots. So now we are looking at a 256 cross 512 matrix. The entire screen is divided into 256 rows, and each row has 512 pixels. That's, and they are black and white pixels. That means if it is 0, that means that that small part will be dark. If it is 1, that small dot will be bright. So it is black or white, it will be dark or white. So you just see a black and white picture on your screen. By lighting up certain pixels and darkening something, you get some images and all those things. So the entire screen will be either that, every dot can be made dark or white, and you can get your desired photos or images or whatever you want on the screen. Now that means a screen is basically represented by a 256 cross 512 matrix of bits. So 250, so let us see some calculation here. If I have a 256 2^8, 512 is 2^9, that means the entire screen can be represented as a 2^17 bits, that means 2^14 bytes. Now in our memories that we have designed in the sequential, we each memory has 2 bytes, that is 16 bit words. So we need 2^13 locations, right, 2^14 bytes, that means 2^13 location, because each location can store 2 bytes. So totally that means we need an 8 KB RAM, so 8 kilobyte addressable, each location word will store 16 bits. So if I have an 8 KB RAM with each location storing 2 bytes each and 8 KB addressable, then I basically can store this entire screen there, right. So, if I look at so your memory that is allocated for the screen starts at 0x4000 and from there 8 KB locations, 8 KB is something like 2 power 13, right. So, it goes to 2 power 13 locations from here. So, 2 power 13 will be 0x4FFF, right, because 2, so this is 4000, say 4FFF, totally this is 8 KB, no, 5FFF, right, you can go up to 5FFF, all the entire 8 KB can come here. So, 0x4000 is nothing but 16384. So, if I want to find the in this matrix of 256 cross 512 bits, if I want to find the seat, if I say I want to find the R comma seat bit, that R comma seat bit will be stored in the RAM, which is 16384 plus that row into 32 plus column divided by 16, this is the bit where it will be stored, okay. So, you can so in this is the address, in this address you can take this whatever content is there. So, the C modulo 16th bit in this address. So, this will give you in this address, in this RAM of this address, you will get some 16 bit number and you should take the C remainder 16, that bit you should take. So, this is basically. So, if you are given, if you want the R comma C, go to this address and in this address, so you compute C remainder 16, this is C integer division 16. So, go to this particular address, get those 16 bits, in those 16 bits retrieve this C modulo 16th bit and that will be this R comma C bit. So, this is a very simple matrix calculation. So, we can do that. So, suppose I want to write into that bit, go and set that bit, that will become 1. If I want to brighten that bit, make it 1, brighten that pixel, make it 1, if you want to darken that pixel, go and make it 0. So, like that I can write every bit into this screen and change whatever I want on the screen. So, this is memory mapped I/O for the screen. For the keyboard, suppose the user presses something. So, there is a memory map 0x6000 allotted for the keyboard. So, the moment the user presses a key, then immediately what will happen is that the corresponding there will be a corresponding 16 bit code. The corresponding ASCII code, right, right, the corresponding ASCII code, it is 16 bit ASCII code, okay, right, the corresponding 16 bit ASCII code appears in this screen, right. When no key is pressed, 0 appears. When no key is pressed, it at 0x6000. When some key is pressed, a 16 bit ASCII code essentially gets loaded to this 6000. In addition, there are certain special keys which are in figure 4.6 of page 71 of the book. Very quickly, we can see that there are, you will have new line, backspace, left arrow, right arrow, down arrow, home. So, this will, the corresponding code will be 128, 129, 130, 131, 132. There is an up arrow also, it should be 131, 132, 133 and home will be 134. End, page up, page down, insert, delete, escape. So, 135, 136, 137, 138. 139 and 140 and then F1 to F12 the function keys, which will be 141 to 152. So, these special for the special keys that you see on the normal keyboard, when you press that, these are the values that will get entered onto 0x6000. So, there is a keyboard controller which will basically understand which key you have pressed and it will get that corresponding ASCII code or these special codes, and this will basically go and load it into 0x6000. So, at the processor hack, when it wants to know what you have entered, it will go to 0x6000 and it will find out what you have entered there, and based on that it will start processing. So, this is basically how the basic keyboard, that is the input handling, happens. So, I/O handling is also very important, and so the way the processor communicates with the device and the way the processor takes value from the keyboard, we have just everything happens through memory, and so this is called memory mapped I/O. So, one of the thing that we need to see inside the program, the moment I say at screen, then in your A register 0x4000, which is the value 16384, will be loaded into your A register. This is taken care of. So, then anything that you want to write into the screen, you can do after this. So, if you just say M, then M of A will be M of that screen or whatever offset. So, I can go and increment this A, I can make A equal to A plus 1 or whatever, I can increment this and then I can say A equal to A plus M, A plus D. I can increment this and which I can access different aspects of this, different pixels of this screen, right, and then darken it or lighten it. So this is something possible. Similarly, I can say at keyboard and basically I can read the value. So, that immediately I say M, this is M of that 0x6000, which is M of 24576. So, I can do both to basically read from the keyboard or write into the screen. So this is about memory mapped I/O. So, with this we come to an some understanding of how the basic instruction set architecture works, and we looked at two types of instructions, namely A and C. A is very straightforward, C is essentially how we encoded C so that it maps on to our original ALU that we have designed. We saw a one-to-one correspondence between that. And then now what we will do as a part of this project, project 4 that you need to be doing here, we need to actually write some assembly code and see how it is mapping on to the CPU, mapping on to the hack architecture. So, that project will be very interesting, it's a very simple project. We will be talking about that in the module P3. That will be following this. Thank you.